Okay, thank you for the introduction. Actually, this is two different institutions. One is the department where I belong to as an educationalist and education researcher at the Department of Education, with a specific branch dealing with vocational education and technologies, and the other is a research unit at the a central research unit, both located at the Dresden University of Technology. And now I'm very lucky to give my presentation here in front of such an interested and I would say inspiring for me and hopefully inspired audience. Okay, the topic. The topic chosen here is a combination of different aspects when discussing the issue before with the organizers of the conference. We agreed that it should be a linkage between research methodological aspects, policy, and even the specific presentation of the case of the research network in Saxony, which is another research alliance, but a local alliance in one of the states of Germany. And so I have organized my presentation in four sections. First, I will talk a bit about the digitization of Web 2.0. I think this is some aspects that you are already aware of, and perhaps some additions. Then I will focus a bit more specifically on the concept of e-science and not so much outline what's the difference between e-science and science 2.0, because, well, terminology is always a question of history, and it brings many further aspects that are just not to be discussed in every detail in such a brief presentation. However, then I will continue with the focus on the what I would call design-based research, or what I would sort into the category of design-based research, our research network in the state of Saxony, talk about structures and results, outcomes, and as well present some data about scientists' behavior, data about behavior that has been mentioned already by the talks and presentations before. And at the very end, I will try to conclude some recommendations toward, well, the ecological, towards the policy makers, and the with a focus on governance and sustainability. Let me come to the first point. Well, there is a few aspects that are very influential when we talk about digitization and Web 2.0. The communication has changed a lot. Of course, we are all aware that our working day is completely organized by using computers, equipment like this what we have here, but other technologies or other mobile technologies as well. One of the latest developments is that in the last year, worldwide, there were 1.2 billion mobile devices, touch-based devices like iPads and such devices sold, but only 0.3 billion laptops and computers. So you see there's a huge change, another huge change going on, and I think when looking into the your equipment here, what I can see so far, I'm not sure if we have already taken this into account enough. Okay, so communication is organized in a mediated way. Our collaboration is as well, is not affected anymore by the social and local differences. We can be at the same place. These talks will be streamed and will be recorded and will be available or made available to audiences at other places simultaneously, and as well we can continue this and others may participate in our research and our academic activities. This is true for our conference, but this is true for many of the other activities we have in the academic sector as well, as it is applicable to industry and spheres of our private life. So collaboration is a very important factor. Another one, for me, interesting as well, is the question of authority. This has been partly addressed by the speaker before, I would say or guess in a sense that, of course, knowledge creation is taking place in computer-mediated communities, and we have some new or changing structures. Those are most influential who have the capability to use the media technologies in a most profitable way, and not so much those anymore who have the best awareness of a certain topic. It's a huge, so method overruns the topics or the competency in a certain academic area, at least to some extent, and so we have very heavy influences here on the areas of communication, collaboration, authority. What can we conclude for science? Well, science is going to be transformed, especially by the influence of those information and communication technologies, and I would go so far to say, well, it can even the way how we think itself. There is a very strong discussion going on that has been by a not so scientific, has been triggered by a not so scientific book of a German psychiatrist. I think it's for clear that these technologies of information transfer and memory support, of course, change the way how we need to handle information as well for our academic endeavors. In that sense, we come to a new world of knowledge, a network of structures and information that is linked by, of course, on the basis of the internet, and this has a very strong meaning for science because it becomes always accessible. Information can be addressed or can be generated as well by different stakeholders, individuals and organizations outside science, and so we also also move into a new competition of for new ideas and the best concepts that leaves the classical scheme of a very close peer review setting. Okay, what is e-science in such a context? Well, the term e-science has somewhat of a history that for me goes back to the to technologies related to high performance computing and computer networks. We had funding initiatives throughout Europe and special national initiatives in Germany, in the UK and in other countries of Europe, in the US as well. And however, we would describe it for our research network, as you can see it here in orange, as the expansion of academic activities through the integration of information and communication technologies in all areas and disciplines of scientific research, communication, and dissemination of knowledge. So this goes, of course, beyond a pure infrastructural aspect. Now we could discuss if the term e-science is most appropriate or not, but in that sense we are part of a development, I would say, and it's perhaps not a completely perfect concept for a still ongoing development. The e-science network Saxony, what is our research context, is a joint network of the German of the universities and colleges in the German federal state of Saxony, and it's financed by a budget coming from the European Social Funds that has been put to this effort by the local state ministry since 2011. And here we have a large group of research projects that are developed, and I will focus on that more specifically later on. The principal goal is to trigger the basic research in very different areas with a special focus on research methodology and additionally a special focus on developing tools and technologies for supporting scientists' behavior. Okay, kind of a brief introduction. Second step, what about the role of e-science for the research process itself? Well, if we see e-science or electronic science as a very influential moment in different aspects of research methodology. Of course, we need to talk about research methodology itself. And we can see that we have those new infrastructures, so-called cyber infrastructures, or as it is labeled here by the association, science 2.0 infrastructures with a closer linkage to the social media technology as a broader development in science. And it seems to become the new backbone for any scientific activity using this kind of networked communication and communication technologies. As I said before, there is a one strong focus on the grid and cloud technologies. However, there's another strong focus on cooperative academic behavior, not only peer review processes, but joint and collaborative projects and research activities that are conducted by research groups and research stakeholders coming from different institutions or coming from different countries, from different disciplines eventually. And I would also confirm that there is a strengthening of the, bridging between different disciplines. So there is a stronger interdisciplinary movement in science triggered by the using of this kind of e-science technologies. If you have a look specifically into the social sciences that deal with human behavior, with organizational development, with individual learning processes, with many other aspects related to individuals and social entities, then we can, I would say, well, our life already takes place in a digital lab using this kind of technologies or such devices or any other device which is widely used not only for professional activity, I would say even more for private activity. And the digitization of our scientific work has already happened. On the other hand, it is for me quite likely that the scientists are not really aware of this kind of influence and change from a methodological point of view. So methodology is affected quite a lot. However, scientists are not yet ready to confirm this by their own activities, at least a huge variety, a large amount of us. If I say the life takes place in a digital lab, what does it mean? Well, for example, if this communication here is recorded, then we do not need any additional process anymore for using this for a text interpretation afterwards. Just only a few years ago, it was still necessary to have very, to add additional activity to record communication, to make it, to store it, and to make it available as input for research. Nowadays, this just is happening, especially if most of our communication is going on in an electronic or computer-mediated and supported way, then we have all this available for further activity. And I would go so far to say, well, this is practically means that we will overcome the divide between the lab setting and the everyday setting. That means the digitality kills this divide. So our digital life takes place in a lab. Very interesting, for me at least. I hope I can create some interest in this kind of interpretation as well for you. Okay, second aspect, when saying digitization has already happened in many areas of science, well, we have the digital libraries, we have the open access infrastructures, we have dissertation servers for doctoral thesis since 15, 20 years almost. We have online research technologies for surveys and questionnaires. We have conference management systems. We have virtual labs, More and more often, we do online assessments with our junior researchers. We produce digital texts. We have nice statistics that confirm that most of our doctoral students, or the majority, is using digital literature instead of printed material. I know that you are aware of this, but I'd just like to mention it again. We have also multimedia formats like videography and, well, more interactive three-dimensional contents as well. So digital tools, digital technologies are, well, widely available in our daily work as scientists. So it might be a bit strong, but I would say the academic work, at least the work, not the consciousness, but the work has already arrived completely in the digital world. Academic work without digital infrastructures isn't possible anymore. I already said this, there's a lack of focus concerning the, well, evaluation of methodological aspects, what it means for our research activity if we use this computer IT-based structures, and of course, in the next step, one would need to answer the question, do I choose my Web 2.0 or my e-science tools consciously, or does it just happen to me because it's available, or because someone else has purchased the software, the computer, or has chosen how the website or how the online survey tool should look like? So there needs to be a stronger theoretically driven and empirically confirmed awareness of what's going on with our research behavior. I think this is an important demand, and this should be part of the training of research staff as well as the activity when completing research projects and doing publications, to have focus on why did we choose this kind of media support for completing our research. Okay, third step, design-based research. I have not planned to spend the time now for explaining the term of design-based research, because I think most of you have already already came across this term, and I like to introduce the focus of and the profile of our, what I would label, design-based research approach, the eScience Research Network in the German state of Saxony. Actually, in this research network, which is running since 2011, we have the participation of all German, Saxon colleges and universities, organized in a well, similar way. We have three headquarters in Leipzig, in Freiberg, and in Dresden at different types of universities. In Freiberg, it's a mountain research university of technology. In Leipzig, it's a college of applied sciences with a special focus on technology. And in Dresden, it's the Technische Universität Dresden, University of Technology. And our focus in this research network is on methods, on processes of research, on technologies, of course, but as well on the practices and the skills of the people doing the research activities. And our research team is interdisciplinary. We have three thematic clusters dealing with e-learning, so more knowledge-related and knowledge-transfer-related, with e-business, more with the administrative part, and then we have another cluster dealing with e-systems, so the technologies and tools used for research activity. I will explain those three different thematic areas a bit more in detail later on. We have completed or still running almost 30 little projects that are were developed and funded within that network with the budget we got from the state government. All our researchers use a joint platform as a integrated research environment. This will be presented later on today by Dr. Tonchev, who is part of the audience here. Then we do as well evaluations and observations of the behavior of our researchers, and this will be presented later on today. We did a first survey where the data comes from that I will show in the next step then in the years 2012 and 13, and we just completed another survey with the support of the research Leibniz Research Alliance, which is just going to be presented here for this conference. And this is covering now the whole Germany and not only Saxony anymore. And those data will be presented by Dr. Albrecht and Dr. Pscheider, who attend this conference as well this afternoon. And later on this year, we have another academic exchange activity. This is a conference taking place in the city of Leipzig. Deadline is only in a few days, so if you are still interested, you may join. Okay, what are the thematic areas? I said we have e-learning, we have e-business, we have e-systems as three areas. This was our design, which we developed already before getting the funding. Our idea was that we need to have some concept of how to sort it, the different fields of interest, and so we were starting with the different academic disciplines. E-learning, of course, is widely developed in the academic education sector. We have a strong background here, especially in the state of Saxony, because we are running a joint platform. We have some partnering universities as well, and so we said, well, this could be one of the areas of interest. I do not go in further detail here, but I think you are aware of the concept of online or e-learning. Now we have a number of projects that are just currently funded, and I think this is even more interesting. I did not translate the topics for those for the presentation, but it's just to give an overview of what is the focus here. There is the mapping of collaborations activities is one project. E-portfolios is another issue. Modeling e-research or learning how to develop skills for e-research is another topic. Easy accessible online examinations or user-generated assessments in academic education, and as well as scripts for joint learning by using video-based material. You see, there's a strong focus in the knowledge transfer education perspective here in the e-learning cluster of our network. The second cluster that is now coordinated by the University of Applied Sciences in Leipzig is the e-systems cluster. Here, the already mentioned platform is developed. That is a joint research surrounding meeting place for those who are running the little projects, and it should in the longer run become an infrastructure available for all other researchers at our colleges and universities as well. And of course the idea here is has a stronger focus on which technologies, which e-infrastructures are used for individual work in a lab. To give a few examples, we have projects dealing with a security concepts, with a management of ontologies, with a data management, with visualization in relation to publications, and with the some crowd and developmental methods in a mashup context. So there's a stronger software development focus here in this kind, in this area of our network. Third and last cluster is the what we have labeled e-business. Here we deal with organizational and administrative aspects. And this is led by colleagues who have a strong background in the business informatics sector, coming from the University of Technology in Freiberg. And here we have as well a linkage to the sustainability of the tools developed to the economic market. So the idea of the funding is, of course, to create something that is valuable for the whole society or the local labor market. And here we have also a focus on the business processes that are relevant for academic activity, for sharing knowledge, for producing innovation, and how this is going to be supported by better understanding the role of information and communication technologies and e-science tools. You see, there's another large group of specific activities that are funded in our network, dealing with, well, ontologies again, but often with the visualization of process data, with the idea that a better presentation of data is well needed for understanding better how a process of research is going on, and finally with other more analytically driven projects. Okay, so now I'm asking, how many minutes do I still have? That's okay. Let me briefly come to the online survey we did. We had a strong focus on, or strong interest on, understanding what our scientists are really doing. And so we did in 2012 a survey that has been published then, where the results had been published in 2013 in the first research report by using an online survey tool with, well, a representative group of all scientists, from all scientists in the state of Saxony, almost 800 answers, and we were then able to have a bit better understanding what kind of Web 2.0 applications are used. And what you see here is that we have a wide usage of wikis, for example, for reading mainly. And of course, if we see here, for example, that 97% of our scientists are using wikis for reading, this would be, this is in contradiction with the well often heard explanation towards students, don't use wikis, this is poor information, it's not suitable at all. But our scientists, well, they already read it. But on the other hand, you can see a bit more down here, they don't write there, so they are not. I would explain it in a way, they are not really comfortable by being present there. This has already been explained before, but there is, you can find many such contradictions in the data we have collected here. Okay, I will jump over this and just say that we have found as well a larger difference between the disciplines, even though we, I would confirm that in the longer run, disciplines would move closer to a similar social media using behavior. Now we have disciplines who are more communicative and use a certain part of the technologies, and others are more, well, are a bit later and are not so much advanced in introducing this kind of technology. And we have a difference between the social sciences and the engineering or sciences here especially. Okay. To overrun time not too much, I skip those. I just can say the PDFs of this report is available on the website of our Research Alliance, and you may have a look at it later on as well. Okay, let me come back to the fourth point. The context, well, policy is playing an important role here, and governance as well. As I said at the beginning, the Research Network Saxony is covering all state colleges and universities, and indeed we have a task force that has been set up by the State Rectors Conference already 7 years ago, and this task force is responsible to steer development overlapping the interest of a single university in the area of online learning, but it is by the commitment of all the colleges and the direct support of the ministry, able to address other areas of introducing ICT technologies in the academic sector. And so our main instrument is to develop networks and joint collaborative research projects that then deliver specific insight into the changing academia. So if we are able to identify certain areas, then we are looking for funding schemes. As if possible, we organize funding programs for our local universities itself. And one of these activities is the research e-science research network. Others deal with the didactic training of academic staff and so on. So our experience is that the universities and research institutes need to be very aware of what's going on, because the status quo is still very unstable, and they as well, I would confirm that there need to be a very strong impulse towards our scientists and researchers, academic teachers and administrators at the colleges, universities and institutes to be or to become aware of the huge change that is going on, to develop specified approaches how to deal with the challenges, and as well to bridge the gap between the research that is taken in a very closed lab and the public who is interested in the outcomes and dealing with the results and perhaps can be involved in a new and much more profitable way. This is something that is rather new for most of our colleagues, and this is not possible without continuous and ongoing support by the authorities, including our local ministries, but as well as the, in Germany, for example, the state ministry and the larger research associations. And of course, as we heard this at the beginning this morning, by the European Commission's funding schemes at the very end. Thank you for your attention.
So many people reading wikis, I wonder how about the percentage of just Wikipedia in this. See what I mean?
Yes. I look to my colleagues here. I think we do not have a specified separation of Wikipedia versus other wikis, but my understanding is that most of the wikis read are the wikis coming from the from Wikipedia. So we have wikis built into certain learning management systems or into other more closed communities, but it's most likely that the Wikipedia is used, which is worldwide available without any specific access conditions.
Okay, so if there's no further questions, I would like to thank
you. Okay.
Dr. Pöller?
Thank you.
You also receive a reminder of your presence here. Some tea from my